Track number 7 on disc 1 score presentation of a Godfather 50th anniversary expanded and remastered edition. Bad news. It starts to play in the movie as Michael runs across the street of a Radio Music City Hall to a telephone booth. He called Sonny after Kay spotted a newspaper that reported their father having been gunned down. Composed by Nino Rota and conducted by Carlo Savina, with 53 seconds of length, this cue heavily relies on the various strings, which I've split up into three different voices, plus the instruments leading the melody. While moments hint at the Godfather Waltz, it is mostly the melody of the new Godfather or Michael's theme. Before we begin to learn how to play it, the tuning. We're in standard G, D, A, E. The strings, which we keep playing in the background, open this track. The way I've transcribed this segment is mostly in doublets. We begin with 4 bars of 4 doublets each, which we can play on the 5th fret of the D. The way I do it is play a downstroke and followed by an upstroke. For 1 bar. Repeat this for the next 3 bars. Then the 5th one starts with 2 doubles, then 1 pluck of his 5th fret was still on, followed by 1 of the 1st fret A, then a double on the 5th fret D, followed by 1 more pluck of the 5th fret, followed by 1 pluck of the 1st fret A again, 1 pluck of the 5th fret D, and a double of his 5th fret. Then there will be a decrease in volume from the strings, and we'll be playing the next 3 notes, still on this 5th fret on the D, as ghost notes, plucking them lightly at faint volume, giving 3 single plucks. Now that we've learned this pattern, let's combine the bars and play through them slowly. The next instrument joining is going to be the bassoon. And it will do so towards the end of the first bar, which we can play on the 4th fret of a D, followed by the 5th, again the 4th, and again the 5th. That we let ring out. We rest here for a moment before plucking the open D. The next instrument joining is going to be the horn. Starting from the open E string, then the first fret, the open string again, and the first fret again. Let that ring out, rest here for a while, before continuing on the open string, followed by the 6th fret A. Let that ring out, before continuing on the 5th, then the 6th, 5th again, 6th again, and repeating these 4 notes once. The next instrument joining is going to be the violin. Starting from the 9th fret E, 10th, 11th, let this ring out for a moment before continuing with 2 plucks of the 10th and 1 of the 6th. At around 16 seconds, we'll be fading into the next segment, where the strings in the background continue, so we're going to be repeating the pattern we've learned for the opening segment. The first 4 bars again are going to consist of 4 doublets, but this time on the 6th fret of the D. Which we repeat for 3 bars here. And then the 5th bar is going to consist of 2 doublets. Then the clarinet joins, beginning on the 4th fret of the E, after a moment followed by the 7th, the 6th, and the 3rd. That will let ring out, before continuing on the 6th fret A, then the 2nd fret E, after a moment, 4th, 2nd, and the 6th fret A. Next joining are more strings at lower pitches. Which can be played on the open D string, followed by the first fret, the open string again, and the first fret again. At 29 seconds, the strings in the background continue. Which is a pluck of a 6th fret of the G. Let the string out as much as the mandolin can, but more to that in a moment. And after a good while, we'll play 2 doubles of the 2nd fret of the D, followed by the 3rd, letting the string out, and then at the end of the bar, the 4th. Joining with those strings is the flute. We're on the 9th fret of the E. Tap the string out. Before continuing on the 12th, 11th, 8th. Let it ring out. Continue on the 11th fret A, the 7th fret E, and after a moment, the 9th, 7th, and the 10th fret A. Again, there will be another set of strings here, playing at lower pitch again. For which we'll play the open G string, followed by the first fret, the open string again, and the first fret again. After a moment, the open string again, and the first fret again. Then the 3rd, the 4th, after a moment, the 3rd again, the 4th again, the 6th, and the open D. That will let ring out. At the end of the bar, we'll play the 1st fret. Thank you. And towards the end of the bar, the violins, plural this time, will join again. From the 9th fret E, 10th, 13th, and after a moment, the 10th, the 9th, which is where both the background strings and the additional strings in the lower register are playing their respective final note, but these violins will be adding in two additional ones, with two quick plucks of the 13th fret of the A that will let ring out for the song's final notes. As briefly mentioned in the lesson, it is worth thinking about whether you would like to pick individual notes as done here, or, since this is a transposer to the mandolin with there being none in the recording, use tremolo instead. If you're not familiar, all it is rapid alternating down and up picking. Not just for the lead voices, but especially in regards to what is going on in the background. If we take, for example, what the strings are playing during that final segment, if we use a continuous tremolo, it would sound like this. Use a selective one, only sustaining the notes that are actually being sustained in the recording.